Hi, Bartosz here from Cyrus. In this video, I would like to talk about high-resolution audio. It is certainly true that more and more albums are released and remastered in high resolution, and obviously hardware capable of decoding higher and higher quality content is readily available. We are clearly seeing a numbers race where manufacturers and record labels compete by offering higher and higher spec products. But is there any benefit in high-res audio over a somewhat aged CD quality? Let's find out. People generally believe that the more details there are in a digital rendition of reality, or should we say the higher the resolution of the digital medium is, the more accurate it will be. This is based on our experience with other digital formats. Many of us can still remember the early digital pixelated photographs. Due to porous CCD sensors available back then, there was simply not enough data to capture the image accurately. The more resolution we add, meaning the more pixels per square inch of the image in this case, the more accurate the rendition becomes. You can clearly see a difference between an image like this and an image like this. There is, however, a limit beyond which there is no benefit of added resolution. This limit is set by the limit of our perception. If we treat full high definition as the limit of our perception, any source image with resolution greater than full HD will not improve the quality, will it? Human perception is not infinite. Our eyes cannot see certain light frequencies, for example, infrared light or X-rays. Most of us can perceive a difference between 24 and 60 frames a second in a movie, but will struggle to see any improvement beyond the latter. The same logic applies to our hearing and audio. In audio terms, our perception is limited by two factors: loudness and frequency response. Let us discuss those two separately. There is a limit to the level of loudness we can endure without damaging our ears. Any sound at or above 85 dB is more likely to damage our hearing over time. It is true that humans can hear sounds at 120 dB or even louder, but then prolonged exposure can be detrimental to our hearing. Why do I mention this? Because this determines the dynamic range our ears can perceive without us necessarily going deaf. Let me explain only that the dynamic range is the difference between the loudest and quietest part of a recording. So the louder sounds we can perceive, the more dynamic range we are capable of hearing. In digital terms, dynamic range depends on the bit depth. The more bits, the more dynamic range available. CD quality audio is digitized using 16 bits, which translates into 96 dB. 20-bit audio is capable of 120 dB, whereas 24-bit audio is capable of 144 dB of dynamic range. The higher the range, the more contrast there will be in a recording, and the more natural this will sound to our ears. So looking at numbers, 24-bit audio is definitely more capable than 16-bit audio. But does this matter in real life? In order to understand this more clearly, we need to refer to the limits of perception again and realize the real-life limitations of listening to music. The first limitation is that in order to appreciate the dynamic range that high-res audio is capable of, we would have to damage our ears. 144 dB can be experienced if you stand next to an airplane taking off. And that doesn't even take into consideration background noise we have in our listening environment. Professionally tuned recording studios usually have about 20 dB of background noise. Our average listening rooms are much, much noisier. So in order to hear low-level detail that 24-bit audio can potentially retain, we would need to push maximum loudness by at least 20 to 30 dB at about 174 dB to compensate for the background noise so that those tiny details are not masked by the noise. You can be sure you will become deaf at that stage. And then we have to consider hardware limitations. The fact that audio is encoded at 24-bit resolution doesn't mean that audio is reproduced with 24-bit accuracy. No DAC chip actually outputs signal with 24-bit accuracy. They work at 24 bits, but do not deliver 24-bit quality due to inherent noise generated during conversion. You remember when we launched our XR series, we boasted about exceptionally high dynamic range of our products, with pre-XR reaching a whopping 110 dB. In fact, there are very few products available that reach 120 dB. These are extremely expensive, and that is the absolute best we can achieve these days in terms of audio chain. Okay, so in order to appreciate 120 dB of dynamic range, we would need to go deaf and spend a fortune on a very expensive product. But wait, we also need a recording that actually delivers 120 dB, and that is another challenge altogether. These days, 99.9% of music is mastered to be consumed on average sound systems. We're lucky if a commercial recording has a dynamic range of 70 dB, with many popular releases reaching as little as 10 dB. It is because of mastering. Recording engineers usually flatten the dynamic range so that you can enjoy your favorite music at a low volume, especially in a car where the background noise is considerable. So in all, 96 dB of a CD is more than we need in practice. Let us now talk about frequency response. In digital domain, reproduced frequency range depends on the sampling rate. CD quality sampling rate of 44.1 kHz means that the signal is sampled just over 44,000 times per second, and that allows frequencies up to half of that sampling frequency to be represented perfectly. So for a CD quality file, this means the border frequency of 22.05 kHz. For 96K file, this is 48 kHz, and in the case of 192 file, it's 96 kHz. So on paper, higher sampling frequency is better, but again, we have to look at things from real-life perspective. What frequencies can people really hear? Very few people can hear anything reaching as high as 20 kHz at a very young age, and there is almost no one over the age of 40 who can hear much above 15 kHz. Let us make a small experiment. I will play a few tones for you. Please check if you can hear anything. When making the experiment, please just make sure you're using quality chain that actually is capable of reproducing high frequency content. Good headphones are recommended. So this is 12.5 kHz. This is 16 kHz. And this is 18 kHz. I hope you agree with me now that claiming that you can hear content above 15 to 20K is like saying you can see infrared light emitted by a remote or X-rays. There may be a few possible explanations why high-resolution audio might sound better on a particular setup. Depending on how your DAC is designed, it might actually sound better at a particular sampling rate, usually one of the high ones. This is related to the filtering stage during digital to analog conversion. Now, as discussed before, CD quality signal tops out at around 22 kHz. The problem we face here is quantization noise, which is present at around the sampling frequency. And in the case of a CD, this noise is quite close to the range audible to humans. As this noise needs to be filtered out, all DACs have a low-pass filter at the output. Now, the closer this noise is to the audible range, the steeper the filter has to be, and the more it will affect the audible frequency. This is very much an oversimplification, but the filter working at a sampling rate of 44.1 kHz might look like this. Such a steep slope will also affect the audible range, mostly by introducing phase shifts. Those shifts will take place around the defined filter frequency. The closer the filter frequency is to the audible range and the steeper the slope is, the more negative influence this will have. High-res audio helps to push this noise much higher in the frequency range, therefore much further from the audible range, and hence the flatter the filters can be. And these flatter filters obviously have less influence on the audible range. Have a look at the comparison between 44.1 and 96K filter slopes. It is also true that the DAC technology has advanced a lot in recent years. It's true that many years ago, high-res files sounded better on certain DACs, as they helped flatten the filter characteristics. Now, modern DACs oversample the incoming signal before filtering, and today we are talking megahertz rather than kilohertz. Notice that in order to use benefits of high-res filtering, we do not necessarily need the high-res content, as modern DACs will oversample any content to a very high rate before conversion. High-res files might sound better on certain DACs because these DACs work better with high-res files. It doesn't necessarily mean that high-res audio is superior to CD quality. When you say that high-res sounds better, you have to be very careful not to be biased by preconceptions. Human perception is very prone to confirmation bias. To put it in simple words, if you expect a difference, you will hear it. Therefore, I would like to encourage you to make a small experiment. Find a high-res file which you think sounds much better than the CD quality version. Make sure it's not against the law to resample it. You can use a free software like Audacity. Start by simply converting high-res file to a 16-bit 44.1 kHz version. This process is called downsampling. Now invert the 16-bit version and merge it with the original high-res file. As the 16-bit file is inverted, you will be cancelling out identical parts of both versions, and what is left, if you save it to a file, is the difference between high-res and CD quality files. Be sure to export the result at the same bit depth and sampling rate as the original high-res file, not to miss out any content. I've done it a number of times and usually ended up having some form of content in the resulting file, however, was not able to hear anything. Do check it out for yourself. If high-res sounds better than CD, this may result from a different mastering. When releasing high-res content, record labels expect them to be consumed mostly by audiophiles, and hence they take more care to preserve as much quality as possible, especially with regard to the dynamic range. Standard resolution releases are aimed at consumers listening to music in a car, on Bluetooth earphones, and so on. Yes, high-res audio is justified, but purely during music production. The lower the inherent noise in any recorded track, the better the final quality of the mix will be. Please bear in mind the added processing, volume adjustment, and so on that take place during music production. So it's not uncommon to record at 32-bit resolution to have greater room for adjustment. Also, higher sampling rates are preferred as there are several stages of processing and the higher sampling rates make the processing more accurate. However, the finished mix is usually downsampled as such resolution is simply not necessary for the final consumer format. Can high-res audio sound worse than CD quality? Interestingly, it can. This is because high-res files may contain information in very high frequency ranges that we call ultrasonics. These frequencies pose serious challenges for amps and speakers and require them to use higher quality components. Any non-linearity will shift some ultrasonic content down into the audible range, so we end up with distortion. The effects can be audible. This is why Cyrus high-end XR range is purposefully tuned to work with better quality speakers that can accept ultrasonic content, while our classic range is optimized to work with less expensive speakers and hence have a narrower bandwidth. So in effect, by playing high-res content through our systems, we may be distorting sounds we can hear in the hope of hearing sounds we cannot hear. I said before that high-res audio is beneficial at digital to analog decoding stage, but I also said that HF content that high-res audio may retain may be harmful for the sound quality depending on the hardware use. Luckily, we can resort to oversampling, which means that we can upsample 44.1 kHz signal to a higher sampling rate before decoding. This will make sure that there is no ultrasonic content present, as 44.1 signal will not capture them, and we can take advantage of less intrusive and more accurate filtering stages based on high sampling rates. In this section, I would specifically like to discuss one commonly spread myth that CD quality is not sufficient to capture the whole audible spectrum of music. People say that 16-bit audio offers a limited number of amplitude steps and that sampling at 44,100 times per second is not sufficient to capture all details in music. Commonly, a graph like this is offered, which seems to suggest that the signal is always ragged and not digitized perfectly. This is again a fallacy. Based on what we discussed before, 16-bit 44.1 kHz audio signal will capture perfectly anything between 20 Hz to 22 kHz with a dynamic range of 96 dB. CD quality audio offers more than we need to capture and reproduce music with full fidelity. While there is no doubt that recording engineers greatly benefit from high-resolution files during production, probably the greatest driver of audio quality is still the care and skill of the recording engineer. That is all for now. See you next time. Bye.